the book, Sodor Reading Between the Lines by Christopher Audrey, in the section about Gordon, you can read that according to notes by the Reverend W. Audrey, Gordon is a prototype of Gresley's design class A1. Let's read a little bit more about that, straight from Sodor, its people, history, and railways. Let's begin. As now running, Gordon presents points of peculiar interest. He was built at Doncaster as an experimental prototype for Mr. Nigel Gresley's 462 for the Great Northern Railway. Inevitably, there were faults which needed correction. Sir Gordon was kept hush-hush, and apart from these test runs, was never put into regular traffic or given a GNR number. He was used experimentally till all defects had been cured and the first batch of Pacifics had appeared in 1922/23. In 1923, therefore, Gordon was no longer needed, and was sold to the Northwestern Railway together with a spare boiler and firebox. Gordon's present form is interesting. He is a Gresley Stanier hybrid. Above the running plate, he is Gresley. Below it, he is Stanner, MLE/31. This is the result of a heavy overhaul at Crewe in 1939. Gresley's conjugated valve gear had been giving endless trouble, so Sir Topham Hatt persuaded Mr. Stanier to substitute a two-cylinder chassis of his own devising instead. Between chassis and boiler, Gordon's running plate is a law unto itself. Personally, we prefer its flowing curves to either Gresley or Stanier angularities. And that was Gordon's origin story according to the Railway series. Now, if you allow, I'd like to share my thoughts on how Gordon is a quite interesting character. I think, quite frankly, you couldn't have Thomas without Gordon. The pilot for the TV show was Thomas and Gordon. He's a great character foil for the cheeky blue engine, and his character has remained consistent through the good years of the television show. The one thing I don't like about Gordon is that he's not that optimistic. Take that away, he's a pretty cool character. He has a nice design. He's my favorite color.
Hank! Hey, you! You! Are you a Thomas fan?
Thomas fan? Yes, I'm a Thomas fan!
One thing that I learned from reading both of these books is that they complement each other very well. A Thomas expert would tell you that the Reverend W. Audrey made up these scenarios because the illustrations did not match. But, in a sense, it does add more mystery to it. Gordon himself was created by the Reverend W. Audrey. He is part of the main engines in the series. But aside from that, Gordon is a foundational character in the Thomas and Friends universe.
Oh, the indignity.
If you like this video or want to share your thoughts, please leave a comment. And also, be sure to look out for more Thomas the Tank Engine videos. Everyone's favorite red engine is next.